Till now we were talking about our subconscious mind, how it was created, what are the blocks in our subconscious mind, and how we can reprogram it. Also about the tools of how we can reprogram our subconscious mind. Today we will be talking about limited beliefs. As we know till now, beliefs are made out of our experiences and the stories that we have been told in our past. So today we will find out what are our limited beliefs and how much we are actually limited for living our wanting destiny. So stay tuned to this video. Hey, welcome back to Attract Passion. Let's go deeper into understanding of our limited beliefs. How much we are truly limited? Because we would say, yes, I'm having this, I'm able to do that, I'm smart like that, I'm having different diseases and things like that. But those are all just stories. If we go deeper into epigenetics, for example, our cells are actually controlled by our perception. If we go into a neuroscience, our brain is actually a record of our beliefs, stories that we hold inside our mind. So what else is possible then if our body is just a reflection of our perception, and perception is just our in what we are believing, that's how we are seeing the world. And what if those beliefs that we are holding inside our mind are not even true? What else is possible then? So let's go on into that conversation, because it can be quite interesting. And I wrote here the whole concept, and in one of my previous videos I already mentioned how beliefs are actually manifested into our destiny. It's actually a quote from Mahatma Gandhi, and he said that our beliefs are creating thoughts. So we are thinking based on what we are believing, and how we are thinking, that's how we are talking. How we are talking, that's how we are acting. How we are walking in this world and how we are acting creates our habits. Our habits creates values. So we are doing what we are valuing, and values creates our destiny. So our destiny becomes what we are valuing in our lives. But we are always valuing just what we understand, right? And we are actually destroying what we don't understand. So if we want to value more something else, we need firstly to understand it. So when it comes to understanding of our body, we need to read something about it, maybe about some science, maybe about biology or neuroscience or whatever it is that you would like to value more. You would then be able to work on that more, maybe to heal your body just by thought alone or whatever you want to manifest in your life. We just need to gain some more understanding to brighten up our perspectives, and then we can create a change. So if we go further, like I said, our beliefs are created from our personal experiences first. But secondly, our beliefs are also created from what we have been told in our past, the stories from our past. And if the stories in that case are not even true, or just a part of the stories are true, let's say beliefs about money, beliefs about personal health, beliefs about what is possible for us, beliefs about job or a company, if you want to open your company, there's like infinite amount of different beliefs. But the question is, where are your limits then? If you want to manifest more money, how you're looking on money, what you're, how you're thinking about money, and from where you're thinking that way, because that's where you're limiting yourself. And as many great people will say to you, that your life is nothing else but what you are believing in. And you can only achieve what you believe that is possible for you. So if we want now to overcome our limited beliefs, firstly we need to become more aware what are our limited beliefs. And when it comes to like to understanding of our personal experiences, many times we have so much attachment to those experiences, and I'm talking about emotional attachments. Everything that we have experienced in our past, we have a certain emotional attachment to it. And you can understand in the way that you just think about a certain relationship, for example. And if you feel negative emotions about that relationship, it means that you still haven't solved an issue from that relationship. And it doesn't mean that you need to go back to that person and talk with him or her or whatever it is. You can go within yourself. For example, in meditation, you can reverse that conversation or whatever it was, and you can heal it with love vibration. What is love vibration? It is the moment when we open our heart, we raise our energy with elevated emotions of joy, happiness, love for life. And at that moment we can forgive, or we can, you know, go deeper into whatever happened at the moment of that, when that memory was created. And emotional healing is a powerful tool when it comes to healing the old relationships or the old negative blocks in our emotional state. And you can find many videos about it on my channel, so I will not be talking so much about it, but we will go further into our limited beliefs. So how you can solve your limitations now, if those limits are not even real? Firstly, when it comes to your own limited beliefs, like I said, you need to become aware of them first. And when you become aware of them first, create a new story. Just create a new story, whatever it is, about money, about anything you want. Create a new story and then rehearse that new story every single day. So you will start thinking more equal to that story. And slowly you will start also feeling that story. When you are meditating, visualize that new story. Visualize as you are already living that story. And I've made a video about 7 steps how to manifest. It's a 7 steps how to do a meditation visualization where you are visualizing a new reality, a new way of living. So something new that you want to manifest. And that video can help you to go into that process where you will be creating new story. New story is actually a clear intention. So what is your clear intention? Clear intention will create a new belief. You will start thinking about it. You will start feeling it as you already have it, and that will create a new belief. So let's go into how belief is actually created from Sanskrit text. It's quite interesting. So I have this guy here. I wanted to draw a new one, but we have this guy here. And from Sanskrit texts, it was written, because in the Sanskrit texts, it was like an explanation of chakras, like energy wheels, and it was explained that way. So the first 3 chakras are actually chakras of emotions. That's why the stored emotions are actually stored in the lower parts of our body. And science now is calling those emotions also emotions of survival. And the reason for that is because when we are scared, all our energy goes back here. And actually this energy becomes stored here if we don't solve those issues from our past. When we are in these emotions of survival, we are in the fight or flight mode. And at that moment, it's almost impossible to heal. So the first 3 energy centers are the centers of emotions, the centers of survival. Then we have here the most powerful center, which is our heart. And if we go beyond that, there is as known as throat chakra in the center of our throat, the third eye chakra, and the crown chakra. And those are like emotional centers, and the top three centers are centers of thoughts. And the interesting thing here because the firstly is let's say an antenna of a thought. When we catch the thought, then we start thinking about the thought, and then we start talking or saying or expressing that thought. That's how the first three centers works when it comes to thinking, the manifestation of a thought. Firstly, we signal it, then we think about it, and then we speak it. And when it comes to emotions, then when we signal it, we can feel, we can barely feel it. When we start thinking about it, we can feel it stronger. But when we start talking about it, we will feel it even stronger. That's why it is so powerful if we speak our vision into existence. If we speak or talk as we already have what we want. That's how we can overcome limited beliefs. To talk as we already have it. To think and to feel as we already have it. So what will happen here when we think and emotionally feel equal, when our thoughts and emotions are equal, we create a belief. That's when belief is created. When we are thinking and feeling the same way, that's when we are synchronized in thoughts and emotions. So thoughts and emotions are synchronized. They are on the same level of vibration, and at that moment, the belief, a new belief is created. So when you want to overcome your old limited beliefs, just create a new one and then work on it, think about it, visualize it, write it down. Writing is a manifestation of a thought. Write it down, like meditate on it. Write affirmations about it, whatever will come into your mind, do about it, and then also react on it. Create new habits which will bring you closer to those goals, to those beliefs that you will create. And never ever again limit yourself, because there is no limits. If everything is energy, from quantum physics, everything is energy. Energy has no limits. This is it for today. I'm sending you all blessings and love. Let me know if it was helpful, and write in the comments below what you think about it. What are your limited beliefs and what you're working on? So have a beautiful day, my friends, and see you soon. Peace.